Good morning, everyone. How about we turn to the inside cover of our hymnals and let us recite together the synodal prayer to the Holy Spirit. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life, and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion with Father and Son, forever and ever. Amen.
Our opening hymn is number 556, Glory and Praise to Our God, 556. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
And welcome, everyone. It's great to see everybody on this 22nd Sunday of Ordinary Time. Of course, it's also Labor Day weekend, where we give thanks to God for the gift of being able to work and the gifts that he provides with us, and pray for those that are struggling for work. It's also the World Day for taking care of creation, the way in which we look over the planet of the earth and many, many parts of creation. And lastly, also, there is Pastorelli will be here speaking at the end of the Mass. He's going to talk to us about the Doug and Dave show that is going to be taking place up in Eagle River. So quite a bit happening today. So as we prepare to enter more deeply into these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father and intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest.
And let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Now Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. In your observance of the commandments of the Lord your God, which I enjoin upon you, you shall not add to what I command nor subtract from it. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear all of these statutes and say, 'This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people.' For what great nation is there that has God so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as this whole law which I am setting before you today?" The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Dearest brothers and sisters, all good living and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no alteration or shadow caused by change. He willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Humbly welcome the word that has been planted in you and is able to save your souls. Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deluding yourselves. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their affliction, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When the Pharisees with some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they observed that some of his disciples ate their meals with unclean, that is, unwashed hands. For the Pharisees, and in fact all Jews, do not eat without carefully washing their hands, keeping the tradition of the elders. And on coming from the marketplace, they do not eat without purifying themselves. And there are many other things that they have traditionally observed: the purification of cups and jugs and kettles and beds. So the Pharisees and scribes questioned him, "Why do your disciples not follow the tradition of the elders, but instead eat a meal with unclean hands?" He responded, "Well did Isaiah prophesy about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrines human precepts.' You disregard God's commandment but cling to human tradition." He summoned the crowd again and said to them, "Hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters one from outside can defile that person, but the things that come from within are what defile. From within people, from their hearts, come evil thoughts, unchastity, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, licentiousness, envy, blasphemy, arrogance, folly. All these evils come from within, and they defile." The Gospel of the Lord. Before I begin the homily, I forgot one announcement, and maybe a couple of announcements. I forgot to mention that the second collection today will be for the new boiler that is for in the school. Thank you for all that have supported for the new boiler. And the other thing is, if you haven't had a chance to watch some of those videos from the Eucharistic Congress, watch some of them. I just watched a couple more from on Monsignor Shea, his closing address, and also one of his breakout sessions. And both of them were just fantastic. The bishop, when he was here, he even mentioned how good that Congress was. It was one of the best experiences, he said, of his priesthood. And I heard other guys at the presbyteral council meeting say the same things that were there. So it's up to us to take advantage of those graces and those gifts that are given to us. But it's not often always where our readings overlap one another, as our readings do today. But as we look at our first reading from Moses, we see that Moses is speaking to the Israelites about the law which God had given them, has given them. This reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. It's the last of the five books of Moses. And what is taking place in this reading is, it's been 40 years since they have left Mount Sinai. They're about to enter the promised land. It's in the years between wandering through the desert where Israel has rebelled against God and the Ten Commandments, which we can find in the, where Israel has rebelled against God at least 10 times. We can find that recorded in the book of Numbers. None of the original generation is alive who had experienced the Exodus and the giving of the law at Mount Sinai. Of course, this is with the exception of Moses and his younger servant, Joshua. The nation of people to whom Moses is now speaking to have all been raised in the desert. And so as I began to explore further, I found it interesting as to what Cardinal Ratzinger had to say about this passage. It came from his book, God is Near Us. In it, he said, the then Cardinal, he said they had this to say about the passage. He began with a quote from our reading. What other great nation has a God so near to it as the Lord our God is whenever we call on him? He said that this passage from the Old Testament has found its ultimate depth of meaning in the Eucharistic presence of the Lord. But its earlier meaning is not thereby abolished, but merely purified and exalted. We must investigate that in order to understand what the Lord is saying to us here. And the former Pope will go on to say that through the law, he makes himself permanently available, as it were, for the questions of his people. Through the law, he can always be spoken with by Israel. She can call on him, and he answers. Through the law, he offers Israel the opportunity to build a social and political order that breaks new ground. Through the law, he makes Israel wise and shows her the way a man should live so as to live aright. Of course, the former Pope has said a lot here, but it's also why we come here to this place, to be with our Lord, to worship him, and to primarily commune with him in the Eucharist. But it's not the only reason, because before we come ever receive him in the Eucharist, he is here with us. From the moment we come in to pray, before the liturgy even begins, where we prepare ourselves by doing an examination of conscience for the sins which we need to be forgiven. Of course, only mortal and serious sins can be forgiven in the sacrament of reconciliation and confession. But our God is always working with us, trying to get us to see how much we need him. So as we further call upon him, he offers us the opportunity to build a social and political order that still breaks new ground. But that has to start with us, each one of us, at what we say happens at the core of our being, or another way of saying what is in our hearts. God, through his law, still makes Israel wise at how she is to live and live aright. So the Holy Father says that this joy in the law astounds us. We have become used to regarding it as a burden that oppresses men. At its best, there were periods where Israel saw in the law, in fact, something which set them free for the truth, free from the burden of uncertainty, the gracious gift of the way. And indeed, we do know today that man collapses if he has to constantly reinvent himself, if he has to create a new human existence. For man, the will of God is not a foreign force of exterior origin, but the actual orientation of his own being. Thus, the revelation of God's will is a revelation of what our own being wishes. It is a gift. Oh, to be grateful of what we learn from the Word of God and His will. It is the meaning of our own existence and what is being communicated to us. God shows us that His presence in His Word and in the Eucharist belong together inseparably. Only if we are living in a sphere of God's Word can we properly comprehend and properly receive the Eucharist. The Holy Father will conclude by saying that the law became a burden the moment it was no longer lived out from within, but was broken down into a series of obligations, external in their origin and nature. Thus the Lord tells us emphatically, the true law of God is not an external matter. It dwells within us. It is the inner direction of our lives, which is brought into being and established by the will of God. But thanks to that person of Jesus Christ, we have the gift of being able to have an encounter with God in the same person of Jesus, the one who is incarnate God and the one who can make us truly pure and who is the one who draws all of creation into unity with God. Let's rise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life of the world to come. Amen. Confident in the Lord's goodness and generosity, let's place before him the needs of the church and the world.
For all members of the church, that they may grow in unity and give joyful witness to the gospel, let us pray to the Lord. For lawmakers, may the Holy Spirit grant them wisdom and understanding to promote the common good of their people. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have served and are serving in the armed forces, may they find your heavenly grace in keeping peace in difficult situations. Let us pray to the Lord. For all workers, that they may receive a just wage, safe working conditions, and meaningful employment that enables them to maximize their full potential. Let us pray to the Lord. For our school, staff, and students, as we start a new school year, may the year be filled with learning, faith, and friendship. Let us pray to the Lord. For orphans and children in the foster care system, may they find protection from harm and God's power leading them to families where they are loved and cherished. Let us pray to the Lord. For all members of this faith community, may Christ the King rule in our hearts, purifying our desires and guiding our actions. Let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, may our Savior raise them up and lead them into his eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. For Jack and Alice Kirsch, for whom this Mass is intended, let us pray to the Lord. For the prayers we hold within the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. Please join us in praying the vocations prayer. Oh God.
Let's also pray on this World Holy Day for taking care of God's creation, that all people may come to be good stewards of God's creation. Let us pray to the Lord. Merciful God, hear these prayers we have made to you and answer them according to your will. We ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As the gifts are prepared, let us sing together number 740, Oh How Blessed, 740.
They surely will
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the all of his church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always a blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy. For you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You form man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life, and that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant, Francis our Pope, and James our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us offer each other the sign of peace. And for those that are watching from at home, homebound, we offer this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Jesus,
Number 348, Taste and See, 348.
Oh,
Please remain seated for the prayer after communion. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And at this time, I'd like to invite Mike. I forgot your last name, Mike. Forward. Mike Pazzarelli. He's from the Eagle River Cluster. He's going to speak to us about the Dave and Doug Show, the Faith We Live Show.
Thank you, Father Chris. I've been called worse. My name is Mike Pasquale, as Father said. I am from St. Peter's Church in Eagle River, and I'm here to talk to you about the Doug and Dave Show. We, St. Peter's Church, first held their first show called Mass Confusion in 2019. And it was marked as a huge success. People that attended from all over the area had very high marks for it. And we decided to invite them back again. And this time their show is called The Faith We Live. Their show is a combination of comedy, music, sketches, but it's also very educational. They poke fun a little bit about our traditions, but people are in the church and the mass going, yeah, we get it. I've been visiting all the churches in the area because we think this is an opportunity for all churches to come and participate in this. For a small parish to do this on their own is very difficult. So the show is going to be on Sunday, October 6th, at St. Peter's Church at 6 o'clock. The price of admission is $20 for adults, $15 for students up to 18 years old, and children under 6 will be admitted free, because we want this to be very much a family event. Again, I'll be at the back of the church in your gathering space selling tickets, and I hope you consider buying tickets. If you can't buy tickets today, you can call the church office and buy them that way. They're also available online. So again, I thank you for letting me be here, and I do hope you will participate. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. If I remember right, I was able to see part of the show at the bowling alley in Merrill, and it was a good show. Thanks to all who have contributed to the Catholic Service Appeal. So far, we're at 49% of our goal. If you do not receive one of the booklets on the Catholic Service Appeal in the mail, please contact the parish office to update your registration and contact information. The parish office will be closed tomorrow for Labor Day. However, there is going to be a 9 o'clock Mass being celebrated. Adoration will be taking place on Friday, September 6th from 3 to 7 p.m., A sign-up sheet is at the script table in the back of the church. On Saturday evening, September 14th, the Knights of Columbus and Nativity Catholic School will be hosting a spaghetti dinner to raise funds to improve educational equipment for the school. And all are invited to the ministry fair, which will be held after all masses on the weekend of September 21st and 22nd. This will be a great opportunity to learn more about our ministries and see where you can share more of your time and talent. Doors prizes and refreshments will also be served. And I guess that's it. Please rise for a blessing. On this Labor Day weekend, may Almighty God always keep every adversity far from you, and in his kindness pour out upon you the gifts of his blessing. May God keep your hearts attentive to his words, that they may be filled with everlasting gladness. Amen. And so may you always understand what is good and right, and be found ever hastening along in the paths of God's commands, and make co-heirs with the citizens of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Our Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. And have a great Labor Day weekend, everybody.
Our sending hymn is number 384, sent forth by God's blessing, 384.